based on a true story, which many people in this country know, a bunch of retired criminals go on one last heist together. And we've been very true to that true story, and if you are true to the true story, you end up with a comedy, which is what our film is. Ben and I started talking actually a long time ago about the palette of the score, the kind of emotional and sort of technical requirements it needed. And our sort of touchstone was a kind of 60s John Barry score, but done very much in the 21st century through Ben's voice.
Well, this movie gave me the opportunity to kind of write a love letter to the 60s. I mean, the minute Michael Caine walks on screen, you hear a certain sound, and I've always been such a huge fan of Henry Mancini, John Barry, Lalo Schifrin, Quincy Jones. I just always loved the kind of fun and irreverence and colour and sense of adventure in that music. And this movie just gave me a chance to just pay my respects to my heroes.
Cues that we started with was a cue we call the Sugar Plum Raid, which is actually the heist cue, when we see them actually successfully breaking into the vault and liberating lots of jewels and gold and money from boxes. As it starts off being a kind of recognisable classical piece and then mutates into this sort of magnificent, cheeky version of the cue played with a big band. It blew me away when I first saw that put to picture. The second element in the score is a much more modern electronic version, where we use the police's point of view and the sort of modern technology they have at their disposal to quite quickly capture these crooks.
I think the key thing was to inject these characters with their youth. So many people, when they get older, they say, well, I feel like I'm 20, it's just my body isn't. And I sort of wanted to communicate that. They're young at heart, and whilst they're executing this totally audacious heist, pretty much in broad daylight, they're gangsters in their 30s, but they're actually pensioners, you know, with their hearing aids. There's a certain sort of tragedy and comedy in that. I wanted to project what they must have been feeling inside at that moment, where they owned that moment.
We're hearing it here at Abbey Road. You're seeing the richness of his work, his writing, and the attention to detail, which, again, all great composers have. It's helped the film. You know, that's all a composer can do is serve the film and enrich it and make it better, and he's done all those things beautifully.